dying. Gotta keep on trying. All the bees and birds are flying. Never let go, gotta hold on. And not stop till the break of dawn. And keep moving, don't stop rocking. Never let go, gotta hold on. And not stop till the break of dawn. And keep moving, don't stop rocking.
Get on us when you're down, baby, and take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway. Get on us when you're down.
Those of you that came to our tour, the Fire Tour, will know this one. It went down a storm, it went down well, and those of you that didn't come along, you're gonna see it now. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Two Sides.
Sorry.
life and times of fight.
Rock and roll, man.
Five, what you waiting for? If you want a three, two, one, let's do it.
From the age I could walk, basically, I was always showing off. I'd sort of get my mum and my cousin and say, right, sit down and watch this.
I think I wrote my first song when I was about 9 years old.
I've wanted to be it a performer, stroke famous, stroke whatever. This is what I've wanted to do the whole of my life.
When I was really young, I wanted to be a fireman.
My family had always been telling me I should do something like this since I was about 13, 14, and I used to see sort of E17 and take that on TV and everything, and like most other guys as well, used to be able to do that. Someone gave me £3 million, and I didn't want to do that, but then I decided to sort of change what I was doing, the direction I was doing. Bought the stage for the first time, and I saw the advert for Five, and so I went for it, went for the audition.
And my dad said, you're meant to be going to the Spice Boys audition. We turn up to this audition, there's approximately 3,000 to 4,000 boys, I believe, and this is like all over the UK. And I knew, to be honest with you, I personally knew, I was sort of was in for quite a good chance. I thought, right, impress the woman, because at the end of the day, if she likes you, she could like sort of nudge whoever. And there was five of us, and they were trying to get rid of one of us. And they would like, just not look at one of you. And like, I was thinking to myself, they are trying to get rid of one person, and it's gonna be me. And then I remember having a conversation with Jay in the toilet, and he's going, it's gonna be me because I'm old, and I've got a beard, should I shave my beard off? I remember going, no, it's gonna be me because like, I've got a crop and I'm an Essex boy. And they turned around and said they wanted to keep us all because they couldn't, you know, get rid of one of us. Gobsmacked.
First thing that we did, we went straight out to Sweden after moving in a house together and recorded the single Slam Dunk the Funk. And basically we went in at number 10, and then from that day on, it's just been madness.
Jay Brown. He's chilled out a lot with age. He's getting old, 24.
Sean, what can I say about Sean?
Dapper the rapper. When he wants to be annoying, Sean's the kind of one that'd be in your face, like right there.
Scott's quite strange. Always the one walking around like making stupid noises.
My mating call. Oh God, you've heard about my mating call. Oh, that is embarrassing.
I end up snapping at him and having a go at him because he's like always loud and...
Rich is like the most kind lad that you'd ever want to meet. We call him the hippie.
Peace, man.
Because he's on a totally different planet. If I was to say, me and Rich kiss sometimes, how would that exactly? See, that come across really strange.
No. No. He's not getting me on that one. No. Abs kisses me.
It's not like a full-on mouth-on-mouth thing. It's a friendly mano-mano. Rich. Mwah. Mwah. I love you, man. It's like the Turkish side of me. Men kissing turkeys, so I've got an excuse.
What does the future hold? I don't know. I hope it holds, obviously, a lot more success for me and the guys. I hope I can just be happy, content, and the boys, and everyone else.
Deep inside my heart, you know.
some reason, TV shows, all they want to do is rehearse all day. Because obviously they want to get everything right.
I've got my camera, I've been filming.
How you doing? This is Abs.
That's Sean.
Just want to turn this camera on.
I've got a few unusual shots. Trying to keep it clean, we're trying to keep it entertaining.
Yeah, stoked.
Don't forget, if you need anything for like your weddings or your parties or anything like that, your kids' parties, I'm your man. You take it easy.
If I'm in a nightclub, I don't go on dance floors because, believe it or not, I've got two left feet and I can't dance to save my life. But somehow, when somebody teaches you a routine, you can just sort of blag it and get through it.
Where I describe the choreography is, it's quite edgy and it's quite physically demanding. Scott's not coping with it at all today. He's got an injury in his foot and today I've just been standing in for him.
I can't do the rehearsals because if I do the rehearsals, I think I won't be able to do the show. So it's pretty boring for me. I'm just sitting here watching. But I've never seen us perform, and I have to say, I think we're pretty good.
Oh, have you just watched us rehearse?
Yep.
Is that good?
You're out of time.
I'm actually going to dish the dirt on Abs here, purely because it is the funniest thing I've ever seen in my life. It was one of the first gigs we'd done out of the UK, and it's like 12,000 arena, you know, I mean, at the time we were a brand new band and we were a bit like, oh, you know, it's a big event and everything, you know. And we've gone out and we'd arranged that we were going to go out, say hello, then get in position, the song would start and we'd go from there. So we're backstage and they've gone like, oh, and a new band from England, five! Yeah. Track's gone straight in and we're still backstage and we're supposed to be in formation. So we've all gone running out. And as we're going up, Abs is in the middle going down. And then when we go down, Abs is going up. And then it closes in on Abs' face and he's like as white as a ghost. And he's like, like this. And then luckily it all came in, but Abs' face is so funny.
Normally when you're at TV shows, you get really tired. And then just before you go on, you get this big adrenaline rush. We can muck up in rehearsals, muck up and like, you know, do whatever, and then the second we're actually being filmed for this show, it'll all run smoothly. Touch wood.
His foot is really killing him. I mean, bless him, he's really, I think, bounced a bit too much on it now. He's a true professional. Hopefully we've got three more numbers to go. So please just get through this last three. I'll be glad it's all over.
Fix, 'cause we can do it in the mix. Now if you may get your trouble, we'll be in the
better on the double, guaranteed that we'll be hitting for six. Come on, yeah.
I heard somebody say, she's at the party, so I'm gonna get her some. Told me it would end this way.
Thank you.
What are our fans like?
We're in the store of five and we're so excited to meet them.
The one thing they share is some of the guys would probably call it the madness, but I call it the enthusiasm that they have.
Hello.
Hello.
It's like quite a few hardcore fans that are there from the beginning.
Should we let the girls sit down?
I don't know. And we know all their names.
How about you introduce
yourself? They seem like normal, like lads, you know, fame hasn't gone to their heads or anything. Tell us something the fans don't already know about you.
I can honestly say there's hardly nothing that the fans don't know about.
Yeah, because they know more about us than we do. Yeah.
I like Jay's laugh. It's funny.
He's got another question.
All right. If you had to write a song about somebody, who'd it be about and why?
I think we'd write a... Who would we write a song about?
I'd write a song about me and Mum.
Scott's my favourite. Scott was really nice as well, really friendly, and we talked about Essex as well because I'm from Essex and so is he, and that was really good. During your tour, you visited some exciting and weird places. Where did you get the best reception, and where did you experience something that surprised you?
Well, it's obviously really surprising to go to the other side of the world and see people with banners screaming your name exactly the same as in England, so that, I mean, that's obviously weird to know that people like you.
Is he right? He's not wrong.
This job isn't, it's not all glitz and glamour, it's not all easy wave and all that, you know, there's a lot more to it than that, that a lot of people always think, you know, well, what do you do? What do you mean, you cheeky so-and-so, you know, what do I do? I work 18-hour days, you know.
It was just pure shock because it hadn't sunk in until today that I was actually meeting them. It didn't seem like it was real. If you were stranded on a desert island, who and what could you not live without?
Do you know what I think you'd miss most?
It's not stupid.
Essex.
Go on, Sean, what would you miss if you were stranded on a desert island, mate? What would you miss?
My family and Ribena.
Jay?
I would miss...
Me.
I would miss...
Me. Car.
I would miss cafe
latte.
I'd miss
my car.
A nice latte, don't you?
I like a latte, don't I?
Who or what would I miss? Probably...
No.
TV.
Well, I think Rich is brilliant because he turned around and said I didn't look 27, so I'm very happy with him. How do you think your fans see you? And what are you really like?
Do you know what? We don't know. You tell us.
How do you
Go on, then.
You're hyperactive, very nice people. How about that?
Yeah. I like, you know, the new faces as well. When you see a new fan turn up and you say, how come you ain't supported us for 3 years? And they go, and they sort of keep quiet. And they say, oh, I like Boyzone, whatever. And we go, oh, good, we got one.
I want it now, baby. Boys with the guys who rock you. Blowing your mind, so you gotta get into. Five, what you waiting for?
Three, two, one, let's do it!
Ladies are the chicken, fellas who not the meat to hit the check regular. Five bad boys, honey, they know we don't quit. Till we hit the rebound, down with a kick. So come on, everybody, everybody in tune. As I boom, shake, and rock a hoodie, give me room.